Hello everyone, I am excited to present to you the latest publicly released text-to-image model Kandinsky 2.1. While it shares similarities with Stable Diffusion, Kandinsky 2.1 is significantly better. Its prompting easiness and the quality of the generated images are par with Midjourney. When I say it is at the Midjourney level, I am not exaggerating. For example, this is a Midjourney output. The prompt is Lion Jungle Cartoon Ultra Realistic. This output is 512 by 512, and this is the output of Kandinsky 2.1 version with the same prompt. Here is the comparison. The left one is the Midjourney output, the right one is the Kandinsky 2.1 version output. For example, a beautiful rose garden of some intricate HD fantastic, nothing else. This is our prompt. The left one is the output of the Stable Diffusion 2.1 version, and the right one is the output of the Kandinsky 2.1. Here you see another prompt, a fancy sports car. These are not cherry-picked, these are the first results that I have got. Here at the left side, we are seeing the results of the Stable Diffusion 2.1 version. In the right side, we are seeing the results of the Kandinsky 2.1 version. Now another very simple prompt, a futuristic, very advanced battle robot. I am not using any negatives. The left one is the output of the Stable Diffusion 2.1 version, and the right one is the output of the Kandinsky 2.1 version. The right one is very similar to the output that we would get from Midjourney. However, the left one is very primitive, very simple. It is not even like a battle robot. So this is the difference of Kandinsky 2.1 version, and it is totally free to use on your computer forever as you wish. So according to the authors of Kandinsky 2.1 version, it inherits best practices from Dall-E 2 and the latent diffusion while introducing some new ideas. As a text and image encoder, it uses clip model and diffusion image prior mapping between latent spaces of clip modalities. According to the authors, this approach increases the visual performance of the model and unveils new horizons in blending images and text-guided image manipulation. Installation of Kandinsky is looking pretty easy. It will be installed into our main Python installation by executing this command. To do that, I am opening my CMD window. First, let me show you my default Python. When I type Python, I see that it is 3.10.8 version. Then paste the command, which is pip install and the GitHub repository URL like this. It will install everything into my default Python installation. If you don't know how to install Python, Stable Diffusion and other things, in this video I have shown everything. The link will be in the description. The installation has been completed. It has overridden some of my default installations in my default Python folder. However, this shouldn't affect my Stable Diffusion installation because Stable Diffusion uses its own virtual environment. For using Kandinsky in our computer, we are going to utilize Jupyter Notebooks. To install Jupyter Notebook, we will use Jupyter from JupyterLab. It is so easy to install. Just open CMD, type this command, and it will be installed. To start JupyterLab, open a CMD window, copy-paste this command or type it, JupyterLab, and you will see a JupyterLab is opened. It will display the contents of the folder where it is started. This is important. Therefore, I have cloned the Kandinsky 2 into my C drive. To do that, I have opened a CMD window in my C drive. I am just typing git clone and pasting the URL. And I will start my JupyterLab inside this folder. Type CMD here and run the command again. JupyterLab has started inside this folder, as you can see, and now I can see the notebooks folder, which is mentioned inside their GitHub repository. When you enter inside notebooks folder, you will see the notebooks that they have made. So it will install the necessary scripts inside the started JupyterLab. Let's start executing them one by one. You see currently all of these are displaying nothing in this square brackets. So when I execute them, you will see there is an start argument. Then when the execution of the cell is completed, it will display a number. You see they have made this first one like this because we already have installed it. So it is just skip it, and it installed the clip GitHub repository. This is why there is an error. Okay, looks like nothing is problematic. Let's continue with the second cell. Just run this. Looks like we need to install IPY widgets. So I click it this URL, and in here it shows how to install it. Just run it in our main Python installation folder. It is installed. Then let's rerun this command line again. Okay, now no errors. It is displayed as number 3. Now let's execute the next cell. So it will load the Kandinsky into our CUDA. By the way, I have RTX 3060 at the moment. I have purchased RTX 3090, and I will hopefully make a video about it as well, a review video. So it is going to download the necessary model file from Hugging Face. So it is 2.68 GB. It is downloading the file which is hosted on their Hugging Face repo. Currently it is only CQPT file. While executing a cell, be careful that you will see a star icon on the cell square brackets. You need to wait until they're written a number instead of star. All files have been downloaded. Now time to start testing. I will first execute their default prompt. Let's see. While executing the prompt, you will see the progress bar like this. I also have opened ST2.1 version as well for comparison. So this IT may not be displaying my best IT currently. Okay, the execution has been completed. After that, you need to run this cell. Don't forget that when you click running this cell, it will display the latest generated image. We generated only one image because the batch size is 1. So for displaying and saving the generated image, I have written a simple script. This Python script is shared on my GitHub Gist repository. The link will be in the description so you can copy and paste it. It will generate a new random name every time when you execute this cell, and it will save the generated image with that name. Let's execute and see. So the image is generated. When you open it, you can see the image. So for comparing it with ST2.1 version, I have written the same prompt, made the sampling steps 100 and made the output 768. This is base 2.1 version. This is the ST2.1 version. This time I have given another prompt, awesome fantastic intricate castle in a forest with beautiful waterfall and trees. It took 34 seconds with 100 number of steps, and this is the generated image. So I have executed the same prompt on ST2.1 version, and this is the generated image. Let's compare them. So here you see the comparison between ST2.1 version and Kandinsky 2.1 version. The difference is huge. With the same prompt, we get an awesome image on Kandinsky 2.1 version. However, on ST2.1 version, we are getting a very simple image. For getting this kind of image with ST2.1 version, we have to do a lot of prompt engineering, but we can get awesome image with Kandinsky 2.1 version. When this comes to ST Web UI, I believe that it will be amazing. So let's compare it with only 20 number of steps. With number of steps 20, it took only 11 seconds, and this is the image we got. You see, it is still amazing with only 20 number of steps. And when we compare the timing, the Kandinsky took 11 seconds and Stable Diffusion 2.1 took 7 seconds. Still, Stable Diffusion 2.1 is faster because it is using a lot of optimization such as XFormers and maybe other things. Kandinsky is just released, therefore it is not optimized. I believe it will be much better in future. Currently, my computer is able to run both of them at the same time with 12 GB VRAM memory. If you get VRAM memory error with Kandinsky, you can use Kandinsky version 2. It uses lesser VRAM. It is a smaller model. Probably it is also lesser quality. It generates 512 and 512 resolution. So let's say you wanted to restart your Kandinsky later. Just close your CMD window. Open your Kandinsky folder, start CMD, start JupyterLab, and now you don't have to do installation part again. Just go to the from Kandinsky import part, click execute cell. Whatever you do on your JupyterLab will be also displayed on the CMD window. So import has been completed. Just click the second cell. This time it won't re-download the files because files have been downloaded in this particular folder. You can see that folder inside your C drive, inside TMP folder. And when you go inside there, you will see the downloaded files. So the total downloaded file size is 6.75 GB for me right now. You need to wait until this start icon turns into a number. That means that it is still executing, and now it is executed. Also, you can see Python 3 idle in the left bottom of my screen. When you are doing something, this part of the screen will write busy. Let me show you. So this time I will generate amazing, intricate, futuristic, fantastic tank. Let's execute it. While executing, you see it is displaying here busy. And then let's display it. So yes, this is a really, really amazing result. When compared to ST 2.1 version, we are going to get with this simple prompt. You can also close all of the outputs from Weave, and in here you will see collapse all outputs. When you click it, it will hide all of the outputs windows. So this is all for today. I hope you have enjoyed it. Please like, subscribe, leave a comment, tell me your ideas about this new Dall-E 2 Midjourney Stable Diffusion like text to image generative model. I think it is amazing. Also, if you join our YouTube channel, I would appreciate that very much. Please also join our Discord channel. You will find the Discord channel link in the description and also in the comment section. If you also support us on Patreon, I would appreciate that very much. Your Patreon support is significantly important for me. Hopefully see you in another awesome video.